What the heck is Instagram and how can it help your medical practice? Today we're going to talk about some Instagram basics. When you're a Dr. Multimedia client, our marketing campaigns improve your patient's experience, enhance your online presence, and increase your practice's bottom line. Hey guys, Praz Murthy, CFO and co-founder at Dr. Multimedia, coming at you with another one of our marketing jam sessions. So despite Instagram being a visual platform, an extremely important component about Instagram right now is what we call copy. And if you've never heard the term or you don't know what I'm talking about, that can be a confusing word. But copy is the description that goes along with your photo and your video. And if you watch one of our previous videos, you know that initially, you only get a couple of lines of text below your photo or video. So people have to find the first part interesting, and then they can read more, and then they can expand out to the entire thing. So copy is extremely important because even though we're delivering photos and video in kind of a quick-fire manner, once you have someone's attention, you do want to deliver a longer message. So it really helps to write about what's in the photo or video and then relate that to a bigger topic or explain more or go more in depth or just have an opportunity and a platform where they're actually going to read what you're writing. Now keep in mind, there's really no other place where you can write something and have your patients read it. If you put it on the website, you're hoping they come to it and probably not going to read, you know, the latest blog unless you force email it out to everyone and get some traffic that way. But if someone likes an Instagram post, they'll probably take a look at what you have to say about it, especially if they know that your page often has good copy. So what are some examples? Like for example, maybe you post a picture of foods that you should avoid for oral care, or foods that you have to be particular. Maybe it's soda, maybe it's a pile of sugar, or whatever the case may be, an interesting picture of it. Then in the copy, you would write about why soda is bad. You know, very basic example, lots of people do that. You would share tips and tricks or oral hygiene techniques, right? So it's the information that goes along with the photo. So it's your opportunity to actually educate or explain or even just have some of your personality come through. And that copy, believe it or not, is extremely important. You want to make sure that it's well written, that it doesn't have errors. Don't write like your text messaging. Don't just put random things in there. You want to put some thought into it. And I had one client tell me that this made it really daunting because when he thought Instagram was just take a picture and post it, he can do that, no problem. But as soon as he had to realize he had to write copy, he was very intimidated because what do I write? How do I say it? It kind of slowed this whole process down. So while you don't want to overthink it or put too much pressure on yourself, you do want to spend a little bit of time and energy on the copy of the post. And if you're on Instagram, you know, you probably know this, but scroll through and read what people are writing. And you'll see some of them write a couple words and it's not that interesting and you move on. And some of them will write, you know, multiple lines and it'll be really engaging and it'll get you thinking and it'll share it. So as a business, considering you always have business intentions here, whether it's to promote your services, whether it's to show off a new product, whether it's to feature a new line of frames that just came in, you want to make sure you expand and explain. And remember, people are only going to read it if they're interested. So if you know you have someone who's interested in your business paying attention, what would you want to say to them? And use those kind of guidelines to start off. But copy is very important. A picture with no copy isn't going to get you very far. And most importantly, you're missing out on the platform that you've been given to spread whatever messages you want, thank people, interact with people. And usually the copy is what's going to get people to comment and interact with you, because in the copy you can ask questions, you can put out messages, you can ask for people's opinion, you could see if they have similar experiences. You can get some interaction a lot more easily in the copy than the video. And lastly, if you are posting a video, which is very popular, you have to remember again where people are using Instagram. There's a lot of times when people are on Instagram and they're gonna have their sound off, right? If they're at work, if they're in a public environment, they don't want people hearing what sound their phone is putting out. So a lot of times if there's a video, people will watch it, but they won't be able to hear what you're saying. So especially in those scenarios, if you're not able to do subtitles on your videos, you want the copy to reflect what you're talking about in the video so they can at least get an idea of what you're saying to go along with the video content that you're putting out. Another important concept to be aware of with Instagram right now is Instagram ads. I would say these are a lot more popular with products at the moment than services or local businesses such as a medical practice, but they're going to become more and more prevalent. So if you've been a longtime Instagram user, you know that what started off as unique organic content, now all of a sudden little sponsored ads get implanted into your newsfeed, and then all of a sudden, you know, with the latest algorithm change, when you post something, not all of your followers see it. So that's basically Instagram's way of saying, hey, run sponsored ads, spend money on our platform, and we'll show your content to more people. Now, if you don't know, Instagram's owned by Facebook, so the platform in which you can run ads is the same or essentially the same thing as the Facebook Ads Manager. And Facebook did something very similar years ago, which was it used to be that when you post something on Facebook, all the people that liked your page just happened to see it. These days, you can post something on Facebook and almost nobody that likes your page will see it organically, and instead you have to pay to boost it, or you need to run Facebook ads, and you essentially need to spend money on the platform to get more people to view it. Same thing going on with Instagram. It's just that we're more in the middle of it, so it's not as obvious, but that is where we're going to be moving, especially with some of the updates that have come out. So Instagram ads are a way to pay to get more people to pay attention to your business and see what you're all about. So as you're scrolling through Instagram, you might see the little sponsored tag, and then from your Instagram ad, you can have people click on it to go to your Instagram page or your website or to learn more. And you'll see this a lot with products. You'll see a little video of someone using a product and they'll tell you how great it is, and they'll want you to click on the ad and go to a website where you can buy it. So that's exactly what, you know, you may experience. So if you are forward thinking enough, you have room in your marketing budget to experiment with Instagram ads, it's a great idea. It's much cheaper than everything else. It's a great way to play around and be at the forefront of this. If not, just be aware that there is such a thing as ads on Instagram. And while you may be spending money on Google and Facebook, just know what would be coming next would be advertising your service on Instagram. And one really cool thing about Instagram and social media ads is that you can tell who viewed your ad, and then you can serve them up new ads or different kind of ads. So you could have a video and you could say, all right, if anybody watches my video ad and they make it to the end, then I would like to show that person a second video ad. And then you could show that person a third video ad, and you can really deliver unique content to someone based on the actions that they've taken. And this is kind of revolutionary in advertising, right? When you had TV commercials, it's just the same commercial over and over and over again, and you want a lot of people to see it. But imagine if the TV advertisers knew that you watched the TV ad and then the next time showed you a different ad or a follow-up ad, and when you saw that, you went down. You can imagine how you could go down a path of learning more and more and more about the product and getting more and more and more offers. So that's a very cool feature, one that we could spend, you know, a week talking about, and what's going on in social media marketing. So just know that you can advertise on Instagram. It's gonna become more and more popular as time goes on. Another way to be successful on Instagram is to specialize. You know, if you've watched a previous jam session, we talked about kind of a niche page, or we talked about the wedding dermatologist, and the purpose of their Instagram page was to share skin tips and tricks for people that are having a wedding, you know, day of, week of, month of, things to avoid. Very, very cool Instagram page with a specific purpose, which makes it a lot easier to figure out what content to post if you're the business, and also if you're following it, it's really appealing. If you have a wedding coming up, if you work in the industry, these are really specific things that you would want to know about. There are other ways to kind of brand yourself. There's the singing dentist, you know, very popular Instagram personality, which is a dentist that sings songs often about the dental industry and gets a lot of views because it's kind of fun and interesting. But the point is, these are ways that those people set their pages apart from every other dentist or every other dermatologist that's out there. So if you're really struggling with, you know, what do I do on Instagram? What content can I have? My practice isn't that special. What are we possibly gonna talk about? As we've discussed previously in these videos, you can take an interest you have, either something that you are passionate about and know a lot about, and marry that with the medical profession that you're in, And you can talk about how those two areas go together, like the wedding dermatologist or the singing dentist. And you can combine two areas and really specialize or brand yourself or have a niche presence to give yourself really a laser focus on what kinds of content to write, what to think about. And the uniqueness of it will actually now attract people from all over the country or all over the world that are interested in the same intersection of topics that you are. So it's a really great way to make yourself different, make yourself unique, have some fun with it, and get after it. Is take something that you're interested in, take your medical specialty, and bring the two together and use that as the driving force for your content. Another concept worth exploring when it comes to Instagram are Instagram stories, because this is a really great way to stay engaged with people, even when you don't have posts or even when you don't have regular content. So the younger generation gonna understand this without me saying anything. If you're not an Instagram user, this concept might be kind of weird. But remember, a story is a series of short clips that is available for about 24 hours that people can see if they follow your page, and then they disappear and they really can't see them again. So it's really meant as a way to share things in real time. So for example, if you went to today's Dr. Multimedia story, in the morning you would have seen some clips of our Clutch Awards that had arrived. We had a lot of awards lined up. In the around lunchtime, you would have seen Chick-fil-A lunch that got catered for the office and a lot of different people sharing that. A little later in the afternoon, you'd see some behind the scenes of this filming and the podcast and the jam sessions. And then later today, you'll probably see whoever's left in the office late on a Friday, and it goes on. And so what happens is Instagram users, yes, they scroll through the feed, but the people that they're following will click on your profile and watch what you're doing. So as a practice, what you can do is you can share elements of your day-to-day and, you know, big moments. And it's kind of this daily messaging, right? It's not putting it out there for the entire world to see. It's not posting it for all time where people can go back and look. It's meant to be much more quick and much more fun. And it is a lot more interactive because with today's attention spans, people just want to look at things for a couple seconds each, and that's what a story does. It shows you something, then it moves along, and it moves along throughout the day. So if you have someone in your practice that's familiar with this concept, it's really great to empower them with a mobile device on your Instagram account and say, hey, share things throughout the day on your story. And this is a new enough concept that there really is no right and wrong right now. You can experiment as much as you want. You can try different things, different effects, different videos, posts, whatever the case may be. And then it can breed interaction and engagement in the sense that, let's say you have a patient out there that posts something on Instagram or on their story and they tag your business, you will now be able to share that on your story. So a lot of times the content for your story didn't even come from you. It came from everybody else out there, and you can get kind of free content and free engagement and interaction. So Instagram stories, really a fun way, I would say more than anything, to share what's going on day to day. And it helps build a daily following, if you will. When you post a story, people check it out and they get a sense of what you're up to that day. I know Dr. Watts on Florida, when he was named one of the top 40 dentists under 40, he was at the photo shoot and the video shoot in New York, you know, kind of he wined and dined. And he had a lot of entries on his story about what he was doing and what was going on. And that was really cool for all of us to see because it gave us an inside look as what he was up to. Of course, later there was a post on his Instagram page about it, but it's almost like a behind the scenes version of what you're posting on social media. And it really gives you a chance to share things in real time and be fun and have fun with it. And so if you are an older practice owner and you have no idea what I'm talking about, the best advice I can give you is allow some of the younger staff members that you have that are comfortable with this to start making stories for your practice, because it will really spread the word and increase your engagement, which are the two most important things going on in Instagram for your business right now. And the next lesson when it comes to Instagram centers around consistency, engagement, and interaction. These are things I've been talking about all throughout, you know, our Instagram topics, because they're really at the base of each one. But it's worth taking a moment to really just dive straight into those concepts. So when it comes to consistency, the important thing to remember on Instagram is nothing lasts forever. Your stories are gone 24 hours later. Your pictures are buried amongst hundreds of thousands of other pictures. People don't, generally speaking, go backwards very often to look at what's going on. So if you're going to do these platforms, consistency is the key. Now, I will fully admit, I'm probably one of the last people out there to get on Instagram. I avoided it for a long time. I knew what it was. I had to understand it for my clients, but I didn't use it personally. I didn't think I had time in the day. But now that I'm on there, I'm willing to bet that I do more Instagram, if you will, than anyone else of our clients or of the people in my office, because I understand that once I do it, I have to be consistent, I have to keep going. If I stop, I might as well never have started in the first place. So once you get into this, realize that social media is a daily thing. It's almost frighteningly an hourly thing or a minute by minute thing where you just keep promoting content. Now you get more comfortable with it and you get easier. It's easier to go on camera, you feel more comfortable, there's less pressure, it just becomes a part of daily life. I'm sure you've walked around and you've seen people holding their phones out and talking to them like this. It's almost just a normal thing to do. And again, it's a way of capturing what's going on in and around your business and in and around your life. So consistency is absolutely crucial. And then keep in mind what you're up against, right? You're up against everyone else on Instagram doing all the same things. So people's attention is extremely limited. You're getting a couple of seconds a day, if that, where you're trying to capture their attention. So you don't want to put too much pressure on yourself and judge yourself by likes and views and double taps and comments, right? That's our goal. That's what we're working for. But when you start an Instagram presence, I want you to ignore all of those things. And I want you to just focus on putting out content all the time, experimenting. You know, even though Instagram has been around for a while and it's extremely popular, in the grand scheme of things, it's very new and in its infancy. So you can try out all the different things you want. Now is the time to do it. So experimenting, trying to capture people's interests, becoming aware that your life, your business, and your life now are going to move online, and you want to share that with people, and that's the best way to get messages out and really give people a taste of who you are. You know, if you're a dentist, think about the fact that most of your patients only ever think about you once every 6 months. You know, when they come on in, you chit-chat a little with them about what's going on in their life, and that's that. Because of social media, they can actually stay tuned to what your practice is doing year-round, and you, as a business, can stay in touch with what they're doing year-round. So if nothing else, think of it as a method of communication that you have now with all of your patients that follow you on Instagram. And then it's a lot less about being social media and a lot more about communicating with people out there that are watching that you want to share things with. And if you focus on that and if you keep posting, either the likes and the comments and the interaction will come down the road as more people join and more people start to follow. Or really the truth is, if you're putting out good content and you're providing value and people like what you're doing, the rest will fall into place. No one even knows yet exactly what will come of Instagram and all the attention that's on there. Certainly not you, the medical practice owner. So don't worry about that. Just incorporate it into what you were doing before. You know, make an extension. If you're doing Facebook at a high level, then add Instagram. If you're not doing anything, start the platform and mess around. And look at what your colleagues are doing. One of the coolest things that I've experienced with my Practice Growth Pros Instagram account is I'm watching what people are doing all over the country. And not shockingly, a ton of the people on there are students, you know, dental students, optometry students who grew up with platforms like this. And for them, it's just part of their life. But now they're starting to post about medically oriented topics. And remember that they soon will be doctors. And then soon after that, they will own practices. And they'll already know who I am and what my company does and have some trust in me. So I want you to think about the same thing. A lot of doctors or marketers will tell you, Instagram is where all the young people are, right? You're a medical practice, you want adults, you need older people, they're just not on there yet, let's not worry about it. But if you're talking about the future of your marketing, guess what the 22-year-old right now who's in college and not a potential patient of yours is going to be in 4 years, right? They're going to be the entry into the workforce that has a job and has some income and has their own benefits now and has to find a dentist or an optometrist. In just a few years, they will be the potential buyers. If you're a if you're a pediatric dentist, the 25, 26, 27-year-olds now are tomorrow's new parents. And they've already chosen to interact with the world in this way. And so you're prepping your business for the future where even if there's not an immediate payout right now, you're interacting with people on their platform today so that they know who you are 2 or 3 or 4 years down the road. It's no coincidence that probably the most active medical practitioners on Instagram are pediatric dentists because they know they're trying to attract parents, especially new parents, and they're on platforms like Instagram and Facebook. So the best pages that we see are actually pediatric dentists because they've recognized how important it is early on, and not just a new parent, but also someone that might soon become a new parent. So when you're talking about doing a new platform, you do want to look ahead to the future and not stress out about its immediate effect today, but think about what you're doing to set yourself up for the future. If you had started Facebook 5 years before you did, what kind of a head start would that have given you when everybody joined Facebook and started using it regularly? You would have had the strongest presence. You would have had years of history. People would recognize that and interact with that. And more importantly, you'd just be really comfortable with the platform and posting things and knowing what to do while your competitors are figuring out. Take the same approach with Instagram. It won't be long before the next social media platform comes along and you have to switch gears and do that. So start now and enjoy riding the wave of Instagram's popularity and building your following where they are. And once they grow to the age that they can become patients of yours, you'll have a firm head start and they'll already know your business, know what you're all about, and that's how you market for the future. So I hope that was helpful in terms of getting to understand Instagram, visualize how it can benefit your business, the different ways you can use the platform. And if nothing else, I'm hoping that you will use these videos as a reason to get on Instagram, create your business account, and start experimenting. Or if you already have one, I hope you'll use it as a reason to start producing more content and take a more custom approach to it. And whatever phase you're in with your Instagram business account, help you get one level further so you can move down this path on this very popular platform.